guys, welcome back to a new video. I thought I'd change up the location. Don't mind my notebook flying around. I was just getting bored of filming in my room and it just been the same boring backdrop, and it's such a nice day today. So I thought, why don't I come and film outside? I don't know. I'm hoping the sound, everything's gonna be okay. It's quite quiet out and about everywhere. We're on like a little side road, so I don't think it's gonna be too loud. I hope. But today's video is gonna be the very, very highly requested travel after camp video, and I've had so many people message me asking loads of questions about how much it cost, where I went, what I did, who I went with. And I thought I wanted to do like a separate video for this because I had so much information about like obviously costs and how long I stayed in certain places and what I got up to that I feel like it needed its own personal video. So this is the video I'm doing today. I'm probably most excited to film this because the trip I had was honestly the trip of a lifetime, and I'm so excited to be able to sit and just talk about it, show you all the photos from what we got up to and what we did, and just reminisce and basically relive that whole trip because it was incredible. So I'm going to answer a few questions first, like what I've had people ask that are travel related at the start of the video, and then I'll go on to explain like what I did, where I stayed. I'll leave the links to everything, like everywhere I stayed as well, and give you some tips on good places to look like at booking flights, like hotels, where we booked things through. Yeah, oh, I'm so excited. So thank you very much for watching, guys. Please leave something down below if you did camp this year, where you traveled to, what you got up to, or places you would like to go and travel to in America, if it's after camp or just in general, because I love just hearing about where people are going to go or where people want to go if they're going to go to camp next year, what their travel plans are and what they get up to. So yeah, thank you for watching, guys, and I hope you enjoy the video. Okay, so like I say, I literally have my notebook here, so I'm going to keep referring to stuff because I literally just wrote everything down because I didn't want to forget anything. So I'll put it all down in my notebook so I can talk through it all and just explain how everything went. So some of the questions that I know I got asked loads and loads about was how you actually were able to book whilst you were at camp. And again, this is going to depend like massively on like your camp protocols, on whether you can have your phones or whether they've got like Wi-Fi rooms, laptop rooms, stuff like that. And at my camp, like I've mentioned in one of my last videos, so our phone policy wasn't as strict as it was my second year, where we had to keep our phones in lockers. We actually could have our phones on us, like just, it could be in the bunk as long as we weren't on them all the time. So whenever we had time off, we could just go and like sit and book anything we needed to book. So we would go to the canteen, which is where we had like on the staff Wi-Fi, and I remember we literally just booked one thing to start with at camp, and it was our flight from New York to New Orleans. We were gonna be in New York for 2 days. So we left camp on the 13th, which was a Saturday, and we just planned that we were gonna be in New York for a couple of nights. We hadn't booked anywhere in New York first. We just booked the flight to New Orleans, and I think we booked a few other things whilst we were still at camp. I think a few other hotels, but we didn't book everything in one go. Some people did. Some people literally had everything booked by like the third or fourth week of camp, which is completely up to you. We just thought we'd be better off doing it as we go along because a few people were going to meet us along the way and some people were going to do their own thing. So we weren't the whole group the whole time. There was a few of us that were. Again, I'll go into this when I talk about this in a different part, but we didn't book everything in one go, but it's very easy to book. There will be ways for you to access Wi-Fi and contact home and do anything that you need to do on your phone or your laptop whilst you're at camp. So it is definitely a lot easier than you think, or even on your time off. Like if you needed to go and sit in a Walmart or a shopping center and use the Wi-Fi and book something there, it's definitely doable. And like I say, you can just book one thing and then do the rest as you're already traveling. It's completely up to you, but that's how we did it. So next question I got asked a lot was, who did you go with? And honestly, we had the best travel group ever. It was so much fun traveling with the people that I traveled with. So in the main, there was 8 of us that stayed together for the entire trip. And like I said, there were people that came with us for certain parts and then went and did their own thing and then came back and everything else. And out of all those people, I only knew Sally before camp, like because we'd been to camp together in 2019. Everyone else I went with, I did not know existed 4 months ago, or I had never met. And that's what I love about camp. Like I didn't have any plans with anyone. I literally just like, you know what, I'm gonna wait till I get to camp, meet all these incredible people, and then book things with them as I get there. And that's what I've had a lot of questions about, is should I book some sort of travel? Like I'm worried that I'm gonna get there and there's gonna be people that don't want to travel with me, or just don't want to travel in general. And that is definitely a worry for a first timer, don't get me wrong, because if you're going completely on your own and you don't know anyone, it is worrying. But there will always be someone that wants to travel, because in the main you're all going with the same mindset and you want to do the same thing. You want to work at camp and then you want to travel together. So please don't let that put you off. And please, if I can give you any piece of advice and you literally go off it, is don't book anything after camp. I literally spent my first 2 summers with things booked. My first summer I had to fly straight home because it was my brother's 18th, and then my second summer I had a holiday booked with what ended up being my ex-boyfriend. So if you literally take on board any piece of advice, please go with like no plans, because it is so much more fun and it's easier. Like it's so nice to be spontaneous and just make up plans as you go along with people that you've just met. It's so nice to do, honestly. Yes, it's a little bit intimidating. Yeah, it's a little bit worrying thinking, oh, well, what if people don't do the same thing as me? But in the main, if you're going, obviously, like a camp, the scale and size of mine, there was like upwards of 250 staff there. So there's always going to be someone that has similar ideas to you and wants to do similar things. So that's how it worked for us. And yeah, like I say, I didn't know 7 of them. So a lot of people were actually asking how we actually went about finding flights, hotels, who we booked with, what we used to book. And I really recommend Google Flights. Google Flights has been my go-to literally for as long as I can remember when I started traveling. And you can literally just search every airline, similar to Skyscanner, but I for some reason just prefer Google Flights, but Skyscanner is just as good. We also booked a few flights through booking.com, which I'd never done before, and it was actually so ideal. Our flight to New Orleans was with booking.com, and it was actually the cheapest option in comparison to every other airline. And then in the main, again, we just booked with booking.com or Expedia when we booked hotels. Some people booked their hostels through Hostel World. I don't think we ended up ever booking an Airbnb. We did look at booking Airbnbs, and everywhere just wanted an extortionate deposit, which it wasn't worth it when we're only staying there for 3 days. So in the main, I think we did just stay in hotels and hostels. But like I said, when I work through the actual travel plans we did, I'll explain everything as I go. So then the last question I've been asked a lot is, was it expensive? Now I'm gonna go through and talk through prices individually. Yes, it probably was a little bit more expensive than what I'd anticipated it would be. You could definitely have done what we did a lot cheaper. We chose to go a little bit more over the top, and I think we just thought, there's this big group of us here together, let's just have a great time. We're all going to be home in a month and wishing we'd have probably done extra. So we just thought, let's just do it. We had the trip of a lifetime, and I wouldn't change a thing, genuinely. I wouldn't change anywhere we stayed, how much I spent in certain places, because it wouldn't have been the trip that it was if any of that changed. So, and honestly, flights and hotel weren't even what was expensive. It was literally Ubers. Ubers we spent, I don't even want to know how much money I spent on Ubers, but I will get into all of that. So that's the questions I'm just going to talk through. And if there's any other questions you have got travel related, please let me know down below, because I can always make like a part 2 of this video if there's additional questions and anything like that. But I just thought this would be nice to just literally talk you through what I did, where I went, and how much fun I had, because I did have a lot of fun. So like I said, we left camp on the 13th, which was Saturday, and I actually drove into the city with Jake and Noah drove us in, and we were staying at this really, really nice hotel. I actually loved it. It was in Lower Manhattan. It was the Windsor Hotel, I think. Again, I'll leave links to all of these down below. And it was such a perfect location. And because I'd already been to New York at the start of the summer, and I know I was going back to New York at the end with my mom, I was happy to not stay anywhere like really central, because I think a lot of us, after we just left camp, it's an exhausting 2 months, don't get me wrong. So it was nice to stay a little bit out of the city and just be able to chill out and relax for a bit. So the first night, I think, was the night we actually went out, and we went out pretty crazy, which was so fun. We ended up just going to a few bars, going out for some drinks, and we ended up in the craziest club I think I've ever been to. It was like this rooftop club, and bear in mind, all of this was within like a 10-minute walk from our hotel. So when I say location, like, we didn't once have to get trains or buses or Ubers. We literally stayed in Lower Manhattan wherever we were, and it was just such a good night. We had such a laugh. It was really good. And then we just had kind of like a lazy morning the next day, and we went and did some shopping, and we were just getting ready to really fly the next day. We flew quite late, I think it was. I don't think we flew till maybe like 7 p.m. on Monday, and that's when we were flying to New Orleans. So the hotel that we stayed at, I've just realized I haven't even mentioned that, I think cost about £80 for 2 nights. Yeah, the price was actually really, really good. I think there was 4 of us in one room, 5 in another room. I was still not sure how hotels in America work. I think in the main you pay by room, not by person. I don't know, I could be making it up completely. But yeah, there was 4 of us in one room, and it was really like so ideal. And the fact it was £40 a night to stay where we were in New York, and we spent no money on transport, it was amazing. So yeah, fast forward to the Monday, which is when we were flying to New Orleans. If you watched my travel vlog, you'll actually have heard about some of the sagas that we had. So the first issue that we hit was that Nicole realized she actually booked her flight for 2 weeks' time instead of for that Monday when we were flying to New Orleans. So that was the first stress. And then bless her, she had to pay to change her flight. I think she ended up paying about £200 to change her flight to be on the same flight as us. So that already started off to just, oh, it just wasn't good. And then we were getting the train from where our hotel was to Penn Station, then Penn Station to Newark. And again, this was going so smooth. We get to Penn Station, we've got tons of time. Actually, we didn't have tons of time. We were a little bit behind, but you only need 2 hours when flying like domestically, so you don't need to be at the airport too early. So we were at Penn Station, we were sat on the train, we bought our ticket, everything was fine, and then we're on the train for about 15-20 minutes and it hasn't moved, and all of a sudden they announced that they've cancelled the train. And we started like freaking out a little bit, because we're like, this could be bad. We have a flight in what I think was about an hour and 40 minutes at this point, and we're still a good 35 minutes from the airport at Penn Station. So the decision was, do we pay $95 to get in an Uber, or do we wait out the next train, which was coming in like 5-10 minutes, but we were worried it was going to get cancelled again. So we did wait, and luckily the train was there. It went fine, and we get to the airport with maybe like just under an hour before our flight, which is my idea of hell. I hate having to rush through airports. It is the worst thing ever. So to make things worse, we get to checking our bags, and mine and Nicole's bags are so over the weight limit. It's just not okay. And I end up literally putting half of my stuff in Sam's bag and half of my stuff in Tom's bag to just bring the weight limit down. And we were all dead on, like literally couldn't have had anything else in our bags. So we end up getting through security. Everything was fine. We make it onto our flight, and we were just all like, it was stressed. For the first flight of our trip, it wasn't a good way to start. But we get there and we're fine. But then we're waiting to get our bags, and Sam or Meg's bags just haven't made it through. They're still at Newark Airport, and it was just another disaster. And then obviously I realised that half of my stuff was in Sam's bag. So Meg's bag actually ended up at the hostel in New Orleans. Sam's didn't. So he ended up having to just get his bag when we went back to the airport to fly to LA 5 days later, which was really bad, the fact that hers came back and his didn't. So like I say, we landed quite late. I think we landed at around 10 p.m. and we just got an Uber to the hostel. I don't know how much I spent on Ubers. I do not want to check my Uber account at all. We get to the hostel, which was a really cool hostel. It was called India House, and two of my friends actually stayed there. So the flight to New Orleans, by the way, that we had already booked when we were at camp, cost us about £70. This is the one nice thing about booking your travels as you go, because it doesn't feel like you're spending loads of money all at once. So booking it over a couple of weeks is actually quite a nice way to do it, which is actually obviously how we ended up doing it. So yeah, it cost about £70 to get to New Orleans, including our baggage, which was actually really good considering I had so much baggage. It was not okay. The hostel in New Orleans cost us about £90 for 4 nights, I think. And me and Becky shared a room at this hostel, and it was actually really, really cool. Had a pool, which was literally the only thing we needed, because I did not realize how ridiculously hot it was going to be in New Orleans. Like, it was the sweatiest heat I've ever felt, and if we hadn't had a pool, I genuinely don't think I would have managed 4 days there. Yeah, so it was really relaxed in New Orleans. We did a lot of just like, we went out the first night. Some of the bars that we went to were insane. Like, the live music in New Orleans is really, really good. I really recommend it as a place. I don't think I personally would have done 4 nights there. I don't think we really needed that long. Summer, who you will have seen in my vlog, she hated the hostel we stayed at. She just did not like it at all. I'm so glad though, like, our last full day in New Orleans, me and her went and just did a lot of exploring. We went to the aquarium, and we just went, had a shop, and actually saw a different part of New Orleans. But in the main, it was too hot to go out anywhere during the day. That's why most of the group literally spent the days by the pool, because it was ridiculously hot. So after our 4 nights in New Orleans, which was quite nice, it felt like the relaxing part of the holiday. Like, I felt like I actually had time to just sit, go in the pool, sunbathe. Even though my AirPods did get stolen at the hostel in New Orleans, that was really quite sad, but we're not going to dwell on that. It's fine. So then we fly to LA, which LA was by far like my favorite part of the trip. It was incredible. I've been to LA when I was about 8 years old, and it lived up to every expectation I ever had. And like I said, going when I was 8, I didn't remember too much of it from then. So going again now with a group of friends, it was just honestly so much fun. So the flight to LA from New Orleans cost us about £100, again including baggage. The whole time I paid for a checked bag, but didn't pay for a hand luggage bag. So I just traveled with my big suitcase and like my rucksack, just like a personal item that would go under the seat on the plane. So yeah, and then me and Summer, actually this was the time of the trip where a few of the groups split off. So me and Summer had booked a hostel on just off Hollywood Boulevard, and that cost us £150 for 3 nights, which the location we were in was incredible. Meg and Sally, they stayed in LA as well, but they stayed over towards the airport. It was a shame that they didn't book when we did, because we could have all been in this hostel together, but it literally just like, it booked out, like it was fully booked. And then four of our friends, so Tom, Sam, Becky and Nicole, actually planned to go to San Francisco, and they had hired a car, they'd paid for it, it was all good to go. They were at the airport in the queue to pick up this car for about 2 hours, and they get to the front of the desk and they just said, oh, you can't have this car, you haven't got a credit card to put down. Nowhere did it say you needed a credit card to hire a car from this company, but they didn't let them have the car. So they were then ended up, they had no accommodation booked, they were literally stranded in LA. Luckily they managed to sort it and they just booked a hotel or a motel wherever near where they were. That is a little tip though, if you are going to look at hiring a car, please have a look at the terms and conditions, because I don't think they've had their money back yet. They are going to get it back. Make sure you read, literally check anything. If you're hiring cars or renting out anything like Airbnbs, make sure you look into it first, because they always try and like hit you with extra hidden costs somehow. So within these 3 days in New Orleans, it was, like I said, the group was quite split. So it was me and Summer and then Meg and Sally, that we stayed, the four of us stayed together for the main part of this trip. And again, if you'll have seen my vlog, I actually vlogged quite a lot of LA, and honestly, it was just so much fun. So we get there, I can't remember what time we landed. Oh, our flight was delayed. So our flight was delayed by about 2.5 hours, but we actually ended up landing in LA as the sun was setting, and it was actually so pretty. And then we get to the hostel, which again, Summer wasn't too convinced on. I thought it was really cool. I will leave the link to my like vlog down below so you can have a look at the hostel. It was a pod share hostel, and like I said, it was about £150 for the 3 nights, but we were on Hollywood Boulevard. Like, the Walk of Fame was on the road that we were staying on, and it was kind of just like this big open room with about 10 beds, but there was no kind of like privacy with the front door at all. My bed was in front of the door, which was what was a little bit strange, and that's the only thing that put me off the whole place, because if that wasn't for that, it would have been one of my favorite places I've stayed, because it was so quirky, the location was insane, and we were right in LA. It was amazing. But yeah, besides the point of the hostel not being everything we kind of thought it was going to be, we woke up really early the first morning we were there, at literally like, I think we got up at like 5:15, and we got ready and we were going to go and do the Runyon Canyon hike, which we'd seen a few people do it. We'd seen Sophia and Cynthia do it, and we were like, we need to relive that dream. So we get up and we're walking through, obviously, like down the Hollywood Boulevard at what was about 5:45 in the morning, which I don't really recommend because it obviously wasn't the safest of places to be walking at that time, but we made it there. It was about a 15-minute walk to get to the start of the hike, and then obviously once we were through the hike, we were in the national park, and that bit was absolutely fine. And we had the funniest morning I think I've ever had. It was so nice to just be out early walking, seeing new things, and we just had such a laugh. I fell down a set of stairs on this hike, and it was hilarious in the moment. I really hurt my elbow, but it was a lot of fun. And then we went to the breakfast club and got one of the nicest breakfasts I've had. I had a breakfast burrito, and Summer had some pancakes that were literally the size of her head. And then we went back, we showered up, and then Meg and Sally came to our hostel, and we chilled up there for a little bit, and we just went exploring. I think we went to, that was the day we went and did like Beverly Hills, Rodeo Drive. We just had a little wander around, did a bit of shopping, went and got some food, and then just kind of got like an early night, because then we were going to Universal. And this was probably one of my favorite days I've ever had. Like, genuinely, it was so much fun. So again, the four of us went to Universal, we spent the day there, had such a laugh, going on all the rides, and just having a day at a theme park. I actually feel like you're on holiday, like just having the best time. And then we actually ended up going to one of Meg's family friends' houses in the hills. Guys, so I've currently come to edit this video, and all of a sudden the clip just cuts out as I'm talking about when we went to see one of Meg's family friends who had a place in the hills, and I don't know where the clip has gone, but like, it just jumps then to like 3 days on. So I just thought I'd literally put something in the middle so it doesn't look really random. So literally all I was talking about was how insane of a day we had when we spent the day at Universal, and then we ended up going to this house in the hills and just had the best time. Like, we just spent a few hours having a really like well-needed girly like pamper day. We were like having some champagne, just chilling in the hot tub, having some snacks, and honestly, it was such a good day. Like I said in the video, probably one of my favorite days I've ever had. It was insane. And then all you literally missed out on in the bit that I don't know where the clips have gone, we went back to the hostel, we had our last night in the hostel, and then we actually moved to a new hotel. So we were all staying, there was about I think 11 of us staying at the Marriott near LAX. So we were a little bit further out from the city, but we had three of our friends that were staying at camp. They'd been at camp for like an extra week. They were coming out to meet us, so there was a bigger group of us, and it was so much fun. It was so nice to get into an actual hotel and have like a big pool, and it'd be like a nice hotel as opposed to more of the hostels we've been staying in. So this is when we went a little bit more high end, but the price was incredible. I think for three nights, it cost us £130 to stay at the Marriott Hotel, and it was insane. They upgraded our room. We had like a room that you could access the pool to, so you could go out the back instead of having to like walk all the way around the lobby to get to the pool. So it was so nice. And the first day when a few of the lads got there, we just kind of like chilled. We were in the pool, went and got some food, like did a bit of a low-key day. And then next bit is where like I've got the clips back from, so I'm literally just gonna, I was just gonna hop on here and kind of like fill in the missing part in the middle. So yeah, the hotel was really cheap, such a good deal, like honestly it was great. Yeah, I literally wanted to just come and explain that, and I'm gonna let it go back to the actual video. So yeah, then the second day we all just went to Venice Beach for the day. We had such a nice day, just chilling but in the sun, going in the sea, and we went and watched all the skateboarding, and then we decided to walk to Santa Monica Pier, which isn't a long walk, it's probably just over half an hour, and then we went on one of the roller coasters in the dark. But again, it was a lot of fun and we had such a good day, one of my favorite days of the whole trip. So yeah, then we get a coach to San Diego, which cost us like $12. It was really, really good and the coach was brilliant. It drove us all the way along the coast, such a pretty drive, and took us about, I think, like 2 hours and 40 minutes to get to San Diego. And we were then in San Diego for 4 nights, and the hotel here again was really, really good. It was more of like a motel, and that was about £120, so about £30 each a night. And again, really good location. We were about 10 minutes from everything, 10 minutes from the beach, 10 minutes from the marina, and San Diego was beautiful. Like, I've been to San Diego in the same trip when I was younger, when I went to LA, but I was also really not very well when I was in San Diego. I don't know if it was just everything was catching up to me. Like, I was just exhausted, but my throat and everything, like, I just felt so ill. So I spent one day kind of just like, I was like, I think it was the day we got there, actually. I was like, I need like a bed day. I just ordered food, watched a movie. I was like, I just need to rest. I was like, because the next part of the trip was Vegas, and I was like, I need to make sure that I'm fully rested for Vegas, because I know how much more intense that's going to be. So I think I was probably out for like 2 days. I was just not very well, and it was a really nice part of the trip. I was just gutted that I felt the way that I did when I was there. By the time I was leaving, I felt absolutely fine, and I was just so glad that I had rested, because I know that if I'd have forced myself to go out and do loads of different things, I would have just been absolutely mentally drained and exhausted and not prepared for Vegas. So we then flew to Vegas. Vegas was so much fun, guys. I think it cost us around £50 to fly to Vegas. The flight itself was like $19, and then we stayed at Circus in Vegas, which was about £80 for 3 nights, and it was so cheap to stay in Vegas. We obviously, Circus is the one end of the strip, and kind of like everything else is the other end, but we thought for £80 I'd rather stay there, and we just kind of like had to Uber everywhere anyway. And the first night we went out in Vegas, we all just went for some drinks. Like, we went to Hooters and had food. Like, the food at Hooters is some of my favorite food. The wings there are insane. And then we met up with everyone, we went to some of the casinos, just had a wander around, and then me, Becky and Sally actually ended up going to one of the nightclubs in the Aria Hotel, and this was incredible. It was such a strange setup club, though. If you weren't in VIP, you like couldn't go on the dance floor. It was really weird. It was like you were segregated from if you paid to get in. Like, you had to pay $20 to get in, but then VIP was like an additional step, and somehow we managed to finesse our way into VIP, and we were on the dance floor, and Becky managed to get us through. It was hilarious, and we had such a good night. Again, it was so hot in Vegas, I forgot that it was going to be ridiculously hot, but you're basically in the desert. It was minimum like 41 degrees during the day, and like it didn't go lower than about 33 degrees at night. So we spent most of the days just chilling by the pool, because you couldn't really go out and walk up and down the strip anywhere in the day because it was just so hot. So we would just have chill days, sit by the pool, go swimming, go for some food, and then get ready and go out towards like 7-8 o'clock when it was like relatively cooler. But yeah, Vegas was a lot of fun. Again, it was exhausting by the time doing Vegas at the last stop of the trip. Was like intense. So me and Tom actually went to the airport together. He was flying home, and then I was flying back to New York to obviously meet my mom. And it was actually such a sad saying goodbye to Tom and feeling so emotional. I was like, this is literally it. This is the last person out of this group that I'm saying goodbye to, and I'm not going to see you for a few weeks until I'm back home. And it was just because we'd had such an incredible summer, it was just so emotional. I feel like I could cry at any given point, especially while I was traveling. It was just not okay. And then I stayed in Newark just for the night by the airport, so my mom landed kind of like lunchtime the next day. So I went to the airport, went and met her, and it was so nice seeing her again. So yeah, my flight back to New York was probably my most expensive part of the trip. It cost about £130, so it still wasn't an expensive flight, but was the most expensive flight I did. And then my hotel in Newark was around £100, I think. Like I said, I just needed somewhere to stay near the airport until I could meet my mom the next morning. And then me and my mom stayed in Newark again, and we literally managed to stay 2 doors down from the hotel I was already staying in, which is quite ideal because I just dropped all my bags off in the morning, then went to the airport without having all my case and stuff. And 2 nights in Newark, I think, cost around £120. My mom booked all of this part for me, so this is the bit that I don't have the really accurate prices for, but I think it was around £120. We were obviously there over like Labor Day weekend, so prices were a little bit all over the place, and was a little bit more expensive. Then we actually got the coach to Atlantic City, and neither of us had been to Atlantic City, and it was such a cool place. It was in New Jersey, so it was about, I think it took us about 2 hours and 20 minutes on the bus from Port Authority in New York, and a return ticket on the bus was about $80, I think, so it really wasn't bad for the fact we literally were able to go all the way to New Jersey and then back again. And then the hotel in Atlantic City, again over Labor Day weekend, it was a little bit more expensive. It was about £180, I think. And we just had such a nice trip. We ended up watching fireworks on the beach, which was so, so nice. And then just had, again, like a little bit more of a chill part of the holiday. Went out and did some exploring, walked down, went, did some shopping, just went out for some nice food. And it was just nice to obviously see my mom after having not seen her in 3 months. And then we made the trip home. And now I'm back in England. But I do fly out again soon, guys, so that's a new video incoming. So I'm not gonna be here for long. I've just literally got the travel bug so bad, guys. And I know most of you that went to camp this year have spoke to me and said the exact same, that now you're back, you're kind of like itching to just go somewhere else again. But yeah, that is a little roundup of all my travels. I literally, like I said, had the best time ever. It was so much fun, and I'm going to insert some photos along the way, and I might try and keep a tally of how much I cost and then total it up at the end, because off the top of my head I have no idea how much it cost. I am going to say we probably average spent around maybe like $50 a day, which again is more than I ever planned to spend. But Ubers and getting around and stuff like that, eating out, drinking out, shopping, was, we just spent it. But I wouldn't change a single thing. So I will try and total it all up so you get a bit of an idea on how much we spent. Like I said, you could do this way cheaper. Like, there was definitely cheaper options for us to do. Like, we could have got buses more often than flying, or we could have stayed in much cheaper hotels, but we thought, we just chose that we didn't want to. We wanted to go and stay a little bit nicer and in good locations. That was a massive thing, was just staying in better locations for some of these things, because it did save us on some sort of transport. But yeah, like I said, if you have any questions to do with my travel plans or your potential travel plans or any other questions in relation to camp at all, please just leave them below or drop me a message and I'll happily answer all of them. So yeah, thank you for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next video.